The water is gone. While we bought our fishing licenses, life vests, and an inflatable kayak, Isaac had us cracking up by explaining that all we had to do was put his vest on and toss him into the fish tank so he could swim around with the fishes.
We are finally packed up and ready to hit the road. It's going to be a great couple day adventure.
All right, everybody, we're on our way.
Yay!
Woo-hoo! What are you the most excited about?
Fishing with the boys.
Woo-hoo. Oh, yeah, that's going to be one of my favorite things.
Absolutely.
My hands.
The water.
Water, definitely. And just good time with family. All right.
Yes.
We're going to get on the road. We'll see you guys a little bit later. I should have pulled off right there and got a long shot. to go down there, but it's just like empty compared to what it was.
This is one of those
6 PSI different from one to the other.
That's significant.
Well, they are only $60 gauges.
Just get one at the gas station for $2.
But what do they do? We're really hoping to camp right along the water. While we were researching this trip, we find a diagram that shows all of the dispersed camping that they allow highlighted in pink. There's quite a bit right along the waterfront, so we reference Google Earth to see how we can get to it, and there's a lot of access roads that lead down to the water. So our goal is to find one of these that'll work for our campsite. That's right.
Yes.
That one locked gate stopped us from accessing all of the dispersed camping from the west side of the reservoir. So we decided to drive all the way around on the highway to the east side of the reservoir and access it from a Bureau of Land Management road that we see on the map. After about a half hour of driving to get around the lake to the east side, we find that the Bureau of Land Management road is also blocked by a gate.
We can totally drive right down there.
Oh,
maybe we could try. But I mean, if we just drive all the way around to where they do camp, I mean, it's empty.
So every road is blocked off. However, I do see trails in the lake bed where people have driven before. So I decided to utilize those to try to get around where we are allowed to camp on the water. Some days just don't work out. You end up airing up the tires after only a half mile of dirt. You can't get to the camp spot you want to find. Even though there's miles of lake right behind me, I just can't get to it. Sometimes there's just too many locked gates. We'll figure it out. It's all part of the adventure.
Okay. So you can drive up there and then you'll be up through it the whole way, and there's dispersed sites along the way where you can see people have camped in the past.
Thank you. And whenever all else fails, talk to Jeff, he'll steer you in the right direction. So Jeff explains to us that the only way to access the backwoods camping area that's highlighted on the map is by boat.
What's
60 times 60
100 times?
I don't know.
Daddy already told you that earlier.
What's that being? Coming home, wait for me.
Oh, honey, that's beautiful. Thank you.
You want to go home with me?
Yeah.
Yeah, you're going to go home with me.
And that one, there's Helen and Mommy and Eli. Mommy, I see we say, are you driving there?
I don't know that we can leave the tent up while I'm driving. We can?
Yeah.
Oh,
Okay, I love you so much, God. And turn them on you, love me, amen.
Amen.
Right on. The rain poured harder as the night went on, and the forecast was calling for more of the same the next day. So after we officially got rained out, we decided to pack up and head back home.
And now you can't even see. He's going off the road.
On behalf of all of us here, I'd like to thank you for joining us on this adventure. Although it is embarrassing for me to share my mistakes with the world, I'm happy to do it in hopes that somebody else can avoid them whenever they get out and explore for themselves. Be sure to check in with us next time as we visit Pikes Peak National Forest and Rampart Range Reservoir. I'm very, very excited for everybody to see Eli and Isaac catch their very first fish.